Hello, and welcome back to this Trails of Cold Steel 4 Let's Play with me, SLJRPG. In the last episode, we did a whole bunch of moving around everywhere. We eventually completed the fishing arc in this game, and caught the Great Lake Lord, got declared an angler god. But today's episode, we've got some more stuff to do, namely freeing our friend from a certain curse. But we've got some optional scenes to see first. So we can head into here, head into Nine Valley, and speak to these guys. Well, if it isn't the Kiddos, and V2. Quite the party you had last night. Hate to ask, but nothing happened, did it? Unfortunately not. Hey, it's all well and good. Doesn't matter how you answered, really. One or another, you get what's coming to you. Can you blame us for being suspicious after you whisk off your way after our way to some banquet? Could you make that sound a little less like I'm going to be murdered in my sleep? Do you mean you're here to help out with our preparations? Something like that. Besides, these guys are my regulars. The contract just ran out, so I'm going to be supporting you gratis. Just this once. Be sure to say hi to Salrida for some point, okay? Anything you say, eh? Much obliged. Don't be. Rutger was good to me. This is me paying him back. We'll open up a path for you to do your thing. Interesting. Then we need to head towards the Arbor and the RF group. This is where they're probably going to figure out that something may have happened. Gwyn and Yigel Irina. Mother, grandfather, thank you for everything. Oh, it's you. I take it you've taken care of everything needs to be dealt with before the war starts. We have. How are things going on your end? Personally handed out an order to stop the production line of the Zoba Soldats. We're also revising the armament production policies we've let the government dictate until now. Need to look into the initial costs and running costs. I won't lie, there's no way we can keep up with all their demands. We don't have a systems in place to accommodate the current level of production. Even with the Imperial Army Caucus covered, the Empire won't be able to afford the upkeep of all these troops. Looks like they won't stop there. They only have immediate goals in mind. So it seems. We don't have infinite resources here, but we're a business. We'll make the most of it. They could arrest us, but I doubt anyone else could run the company better. They'll eventually boil down to a battle of wills between us and the government. That's right, I doubt Idle can do everything all by himself. Don't overdo it, alright? You're not in this alone. We'll be playing our part too. But of course, you better come home and bring Sharon. Better come home safe. Bring Sharon too. Don't worry, Mother, we'll be back. Come back in one piece, Reen. You got to look after Elisa and your students. I will, I promise.
No cringy lines. Interesting. Assumed after that one. The government won't be pleased with us reviving.
We have our own mission to accomplish. Return safely.
That is the plan.
Okay. And then the last one is heading towards West Street. That's why I brought Yuna along. We'll head to the Bellhelm Apartments.
So much to do in Crossbell. Literally. So much to do. Right, into the apartments we go. Speak to Linda.
Ah, didn't know you were all here. My mind has been entirely on the war.
Seems like they're broadcasting the situation over the radio and now the war's about to start. Apparently all the propaganda to increase support for the war.
Decided to keep close eyes on the situation, like nothing happened. Look after your spouse, I expect you to come home safely.
There we go. Speak to these guys.
It's all ready.
What are you doing in my room?
This is for the Ashen Chevalier, a brave soul.
Brave soul is going to be pretty nice.
Try not to let the team down. Right, we already did the pom-pom party, but let's head then towards, where is it? The East Crossbow Highway, the Boathouse.
Boathouse and Crossbell. This must be what Bridget mentioned. Come on, Al. You're so... That voice sounds like someone's there. Could be getting ourselves into something dicey. I think we ought to check it out. Dicey indeed.
My turn. Leave it to me. There! Yeah!
Oh, come on.
Yeah! Ha!
Smash it in.
There! Yeah! Yeah! Yeah!
As we see, it's Zolba.
Yeah!
Some soul dance. Here, waiting to go. And we see one. Mr. Richard. Not Mr. Richard. Mr. Allen. A sinking Allen Richard. Here we go. Right. Are you trying to stop me? Second Division finally signed off and letting me use these things. So I rushed over to tell you the good news. And this is how you respond? Don't you hate yourself, Allen. Think about what you're saying. Can't you see that something's wrong here? Your dream to be in the 4th Armored. Why would you throw that away to go fight on the front lines? You don't have to worry about me. With these Zobas, I'll be fine. I'm happy that you came all this way to see me, but I need to hurry and get to Tangram. The war's not going to wait. All I ask of you is to think of the bigger picture, Bridget. Are you sure you're going to stand in the way of us crushing the Republic? Looks like we've made it in time. You. Thanks for coming. Well, if it isn't the traitors from Thors. Must I heard your work on some pathetic scheme. Radiant Wings, was it? Did you come here to turn yourselves in? Looks like he's been completely taken over.
Ferris said that Bridget asked her for advice yesterday. Do you think?
I'm stunned by how foolish you've become. The Empire has Operation Jormundur, and the Imperial Fortress at its disposal. In the face of such military might, resistance is absolutely futile. If you know all that and still choose to betray our country, you deserve everything that's coming to you. Even so, I'll be merciful. Not arrest you here today. It's the least I can do. Go ahead and struggle right to the middle end, Thors. Same for you, fallen hero. What do you mean by that? You really are clueless, aren't you? You were the Astra Chevalier, the hero destined to lead Erebonia to the greatest glory. But you betrayed us. No one's gonna rely on you anymore. The Empire needs a new hero, a new symbol of hope, and I'm the man for the job. He's completely delusional. Is there anything we can do for him? He's got a patriotism, not to mention his obsession with heroism. Ghost Rider has his hooks in him. His twisted desire to protect Bridget into a single-minded devotion to the Empire itself. I have an idea. See if you can buy me a little time. I'll bring Allen back. I'll try anything. Okay. The Great Twilight is probably affecting some specific emotion of Alan's, twisting it out of proportion. Since it's taken hold of him, he's become more and more unhinged.
In that sense, you'd know that having been a sacrifice yourself.
Fate has a weird sense of humor. Honestly, Bridget is probably the only one who'll be able to pull Alan back from the brink. We've seen others recover from the curse. If this plan works, we'll be able to save Alan too. But first, we're going to need someone who is close to him to give him a nudge in the right direction.
Makes sense. Would that be?
I've got someone much better than myself in mind. He's in the same club as Alan. They were thick as thieves back then. Well, as much as two rivals can be, anyway.
He might be the best man for the job.
Should be at the field exercise camp by Ursa. Set her and see if we can get him to help. And of course, the man for the job is...
Ha! Yeah!
Uno Man. Mr. High Arms himself. So, speak to him. Just have a minute. I need to talk to you about something. What's up? I'm guessing this isn't about battle strategy.
what happens with the Great Twilight and the curse spreading so much, but the nobles are coming. And the most hardworking people I've ever met. In spite of this, I think it's common to backhand still bothers him, even if he doesn't realize it on a conscious level. But his father is a baron, after all. It's quite a divide in terms of class. His parents don't think Alan is a good match for her, engagement or no engagement. Maybe he thinks becoming some kind of hero would make him worthy of her. Everybody's got some kind of darkness in their heart, simply manifests in a different ways for all of us. If I'd stayed that way when I first enrolled at Thor's, it would be just as easily be me in Alan's position right now. Nobody's perfect. I'm in no position to judge either. But that's exactly why we have to show Alan he's not alone and bring him back to his old self. Even if we have to do it by force. You're right. Alan's got 3 Zelba soldats on the skirts of town. We have to fight our way through. Sure, it isn't making it easy for us, but we can't back down. You ready? I'm gonna try and get through to Alan. So I think these two are gonna... Guess you should have known you'll catch wind of this. Apologies to your sister, you know I love meddling. This concerns us. We're Thor students. It wouldn't hurt us to rely on us a little. It's all fixed up and ready to go. Let's put this plan into action. Saving Officer Alan has started. Thus, Divine Knight battling will begin. So, Patrick and Ferris joined with Reen. All 3 made their way. They contacted the other classmates and might be able to talk. Maxi, every single one of them agreed to help. Other members stay behind to guard Courageous 2. Enough! Can't believe you're being so obstinate. Get in my way, Bridget. I can't afford to waste any more time. Ooh, violence. Who's the obstinate one here, Alan? You ought to treat a lady with a softer touch, my friend. That voice. Here comes class. The other classes.
Hey, Bridgie.
Yo, Alan, been a while.
Sorry it took so long. Thor's Military Academy, 221st class, here to see you. Those of us who could come on short notice, at least.
Don't forget about me.
Came? Even Milliam?
You wouldn't afford to miss this out in this. Don't forget it was Kleistinger's hiding some ships that got you all here.
We wouldn't mean how to do this for just anyone, but a classmate's a classmate. Yes, it looks like the gluten that holds us together, an exquisite baguette. The bond between Thor's graduates is special.
Don't make me laugh. You're nothing but traitors, all of you. As if that weren't bad enough.
You had to join them, didn't you? What are you doing here, Patrick? Come to pity the poor soldiers headed to war. What's with you, Alan? You and Patrick used to be good friends.
So aggressive all of a sudden. It's like the years we spent at the academy never happened.
This is what the curse does to people. Digs up all insecurities and picks away at them until they consume you.
We all came here. Alan, when we all came here, we heard what was happening to you. And I have to say I'm disappointed. As your friend and rival, it is my duty to tell you. All this posturing, it's pathetic.
What?
Look, I understand where you're coming from. You worked so hard to get into the 4th Division. It must have been frustrating being eclipsed by many overachievers. Then there's the matter of Bridget's parents. They may not have outright commended your relationship, they didn't exactly celebrate it either. There's only so much that hard work can achieve before you hit a wall. I have a feeling you learned that the hard way. But you know what? I preferred seeing you frustrated. What you're doing now is just seizing power with a shortcut. You're throwing away the very work ethic that made you special. From where I'm standing, that doesn't look like progress. Looks more like giving up. It wounds me to say this, but you're acting the part of the talentless commoner, and that isn't you.
you're saying I'm running from my problems. How dare you, Patrick? What would you know about that? About anything?
Blimey, where the hell is that? It's like he's linked to it. This could be bad.
The curse of the Empire is totally consuming him. Is there any one way left to settle this? Come, Valimar.
Well, Valimar, it's a Flesher metal and Spiegel too. That sword. Am I warming the bench?
This isn't a rivalry. No need for you to get involved.
Green sword's a Morian tacky. Should happen to find it, so we fix it up good as new.
So this is your cursed comrade. Hangs upon him. I can sense the ebon mist encircling his body. The sodency he's controlling are completely linked with the Great Twilight. Regard him with the same caution you would a divine knight. Tread carefully, my awakener. And his friends.
Right. Let's do this.
So this is your grand plan. Can't harness divine knight's true power with that sword. Should a Spiegel. Guess I'm there trying to take me on with that defective hunk of metal. And I'm going to show you just how superior these Zalba salt ants are at maximum resonance.
Green Patrick, the rest is up to you. Pick this curse and bring Alan back.
Time for the follow push. Patrick, Valimar, get ready. Yes.
Makes sense for you, sis, to be there. And I'm going to keep these two, because why not? I haven't got any more powerful herbs because I need more U materials, so this is fine for now. Confirm, let's go.
Let's go!
Okay. We'll try and take out the guys to the side, I think is the best possible way. So. Nice.
It's down!
Get the follow up.
Allow me! There!
Annoying.
Now, let's show them a thing or two!
Okay, you can buff them. Who are they aiming for here? They're aiming for Alan, that's not good.
Take this! You're mine! Take this!
It's my turn!
Interesting.
Shit! It's down!
Trying to take out the other units fast and fast.
Allow me!
Ha! Nice. Get the heal.
Too easy.
Get the finisher. Then I'll heal up. At some point this turn.
You're mine!
Nice.
Leave it to me.
Ha! It gives us some CP recovery as well. Kind of okay with Valimar getting hit, you know. Dark shot. Okay, I need you to heal up your boy.
It's my turn!
Let's get the break here.
Shit! Healing strike!
Take this!
Wow. We're in a danger point.
It's come to this. Spirit!
Nice.
Allow me!
Let's try and take out this guy.
Too easy.
Get the assist. Is that him down? Okay, we got one down. Then we'll aim for the number two in a second.
Take this!
And we can heal Green now.
Take this!
Not here! Spirit!
Nice, he's still in a caution.
I'm up! Recharge!
This is fine with me.
Allow me.
Smack him up.
You're mine. Take this.
Need everyone to do a heal.
Leave it to me.
Not a charge, but a heal here. Nice. There's Valimar. Valimar once again.
Yes.
No charge.
Spirit.
Okay, and then we'll.
I'm up.
Figure out where to go. Which body seems to be the way.
Now, an opening.
That's fine. Okay.
Allow me.
Unfortunately, our craft doesn't do much.
There.
Nice. Go for the arms. Outstretched.
You're mine. Take this.
Shark slash again. That's fine.
You're mine.
Even with the follow-up attack, it should be okay.
Very well. Be restored. It's my turn.
Nice. And I'm going to go for the finisher there.
Enlightened domination.
Smash him up.
Allow me. Spirit.
Nice. And we're healed.
Let's go.
It's just going to be
now,
pure.
An opening.
You have to follow up pretty quickly on everyone.
There.
Leave it to me. Yeah.
Lordly flare. Oh, so close.
Allow me.
It's fine. I don't believe it to be.
There.
Take it out. Okay, we're in a bit more of a better space here. Now, let's figure out what the fuck we've got to do here. You would think. This is the most exposed. No, okay, wrong with that
mine.
One.
It's my turn. Be restored.
Doing that just to make sure we got healing power
take
coming
this.
Up. It feels like
you're
that's
mine.
Where.
Take this.
Go for.
Allow me.
Let's try head. Okay, head's the one.
Too easy. You're mine.
It's my turn. Healing strike. It's down.
And we block it for one as well, which is good.
Yes. Here you go.
Cool, we're charged.
Allow me.
Head doesn't seem like the right choice at this point. This seems most exposed. No.
You're
eight.
Mine.
Take this.
You're mine. Take this.
We're okay. Lord, I have no idea. Arms, maybe at this point? Okay.
Two E's. You're mine.
We've got enough for a unite attack now.
It's my turn.
But I'm going to need
Spirit.
To heal.
Very well.
Then what we're going to do is take its defense down.
Allow me.
Go for the arm swords again. Okay, wrong one.
Yes.
Do a lordly flare. Take it a half.
Let's go. Now, bring it on.
Now, let's show them a thing or two.
That's fine. Okay, annoying
you're
it's
mine.
Gone for that one.
Take this.
Leave it to me. Spirit!
Allow me!
But I don't know which one it is. Try head again. Okay, head's fine.
Two E's!
A unite.
Please, let's go!
Got it!
You're mine!
Alan proving not to be a complete pushover.
Take this! Shining Edge!
Bam.
Alright, nice work.
We'll take it all. How could I lose? This is impossible. I can't accept this. I won't. I'll never admit defeat. I have to protect Bridget with my own hands. Huh? Why? That's what I want to know, Alan. Why are you trying to do this all alone? Why'd you always do this? Can't you just accept our help for once? This has nothing to do with class. You and I both have this something we want to protect. Why can't we just do that together? Together. And then you're not alone. The frustration you feel burning within you. Because you despise your own weakness. It's something I know all too well. Something that consumed me when I became the Great Sacrifice. I thought I had to shoulder the whole burden myself. And I know what it's like to let your pride get in the way of seeing yourself for who you really are. Thanks to everyone from Class 7 and the fencing club, who started to surmount my arrogance and grow as a person. Swear on these bonds we've built, I will bring you back to your senses. Patrick Reen.
Now we spent 1 year with you guys, but it's thanks to the time we had together that everybody is standing here now. Though we weren't in the same class, fin club meetings and joint lessons, we were all connected in a way, weren't we? We all went to the Skull Festival, too. And when the Civil War broke out, everyone in Thor's banded together to try and stop it. None of us could have done that alone.
Lifting each other up is what allowed us to ascend to further heights. In a way of speaking, from our way of seeking strength from each other to compensate for our own shortcomings is what brought us together. Nobody is perfect. We've all got our own problems to deal with. That needn't be a bad thing.
A lot has changed since then, but our bonds remain as strong as ever.
You guys.
Besides, you're not the only one who had it hard since we graduated. No shame in reaching out to any of us, you know? We've got so many connections these days. I'm sure you could hook you up with whatever you need. We can count on the Floriad family. We're plenty connected. We're all too happy to answer the call when Bridget asked. Can't you go do the same and let us help you? This isn't a one-sided deal. So you can give 110% in everything you always did inspired me. I want to repay the favor if you let me.
Same here. You gave me all the confidence to carry on. You may not have noticed it at the time, but it meant a lot to me. To everyone. But I...
We're all the same as you, Alan. We're just trying to be better. Help each other out best we can. It's just life, right? We are only human after all. It's part of what makes life so interesting.
Where did you get here, Beryl?
Nice to see you just as stealthy as ever.
See, Alan, this is just what we're talking about. Every single person here came because they were worried about you. Because they wanted to help.
Now tell me, this isn't the sweetest thing you've had all month. I guarantee you'll be surprised about how much you've grown in the last 2 years. You can rely on us, you know.
You might say we have a wee bit of experience dealing with stubborn arses. Right, Ugo? I have no idea what you're referring to. But I do think you could stand to be a little more flexible, Alan. Relying over much on your own power could make you lose sight of what's really important.
All this... just for me? What have I been thinking this whole time?
It's nothing to be ashamed of, Alan. Take a step back and think. What is it you really want?
What's most important to me? It's been right in front of my face all along.
And so, Alan came to his senses, apologized, shortly before passing out from exhaustion. He lay in the arms of his lover. His expression was one of peace and relief. As in a great weight, a curse had been lifted from his heart. It had been a grueling battle on all fronts, but everyone agreed it was worth it to bring their old friend back to his senses.
No need to worry, the curse has been lifted. It's afflicting him for so long that he's not going to be up and on his feet again right now. Do what I can, but the rest is up to Alan. He'll wake up eventually. It'll just take time. It's a relief. You won't let something like this keep him down. He'll be fine. Thank goodness. Thank you. Thank you for bringing my Alan back to me. I don't think I've ever felt happier in my life. We all really didn't do that much. Alan laid the groundwork. Thanks to the bonds he made at Thoris, we were able to get through to him. Gotta admit, I didn't think so many people would make it. We even had people we didn't call up showing. Shows that we're good friends will always come running when you're in trouble. He said he'll take care of the Zolpus, but he feels guilty for causing it. He should.
We come so far, so this is gonna stop us. It's what being Thoris students is all about.
Elliot, you said you're in touch with the military. Got my dad to revoke Alan's transfer to the second. No, Lieutenant Colonel Lionheart was worried about him too, so I'm looking forward to giving him the news. I'm sure he'll be relieved.
I'll give you two some privacy.
There we go. Big plan.
The next time we meet, be a brighter tomorrow, one free from the great twilight. I'm holding you to that.
Look after Adam for us. There we go.
We'll be praying for your success.
Cute. Very, very cute. Right. And with that, we do need to head back to the Courageous. So we're going to do one more thing today. We're not going to go into the Stargazer's Tower, that's going to be next episode, but we need to have Laura, Elisa, Gaius, and then a certain young Mr. Carbide needs to come with us. Oh, where's Laura? Need Laura too. So we'll take Altina out, bring in Miss Arcied, and head towards Stargazer's Tower. Something ominous in the air. Am I the only one who noticed? Nice, we got some healing items. That's not funny either. Maybe not, but well, there is trial chest. Number 28, which is the last trial chest, so.
A worthy opponent!
I won't let you!
And again, it's an enemy that we have not yet faced.
It's my turn!
Right, first things first. It's the previous cryptid, I think. Gilliga Dragon. Yeah.
Nice. I'll handle this. Triumph, Avalon Hearts. I'll handle this.
And then we're gonna do Recuria.
Thanks.
I hope that this thing misses here. Okay, it's got one.
An opening.
But we should be doing way more damage.
Sure.
it's weak to fire.
My turn! Roar! Helix strike!
Let's go.
We'll go for the Hunter's Wing.
Zia, strike!
I'll handle this. Right!
Nice, took a whole bunch of the break off at least. It's still fine.
Ha!
Flare butterfly.
Take this! It's down!
Get the assist.
An opening!
I got this.
We'll do an Avalon Hearts again.
It's my turn!
Triumph! Avalon Hearts!
Let's go! Roar!
Smash through.
Helix Strike!
Try and get
Behold
the break before it hits.
The soul of Arsaid! Now! Radiant Phoenix Blade!
Nice.
My turn! It's my turn.
Thunder Fang!
And it should be done fairly quickly. Then just to
eternally flow.
Break it down.
Form is emptiness. Emptiness is form. First. Second. Third. Fourth. Fifth. Sixth. Seventh. Eight leaves. Breaking Dawn!
Nicely done.
Everyone okay?
I must continue to train.
I level up, and that it should be every single treasure chest done. Wham bam. Thank you, ma'am. Opened every single trails chest. But I'm going to say, if you've enjoyed this, please like and subscribe, and I'll see you guys next time when we head into Stargazer's Tower to do a little exploring. Peace.